a ninth straight game, 10 in a row at home. And it's Pat Maroon who led the scoring here tonight. Pat, congratulations on this victory. What went into it? Every game has its own story. What are you most proud of here tonight?
I think I'm most proud of just the next man up, I think. With our all-stars out and our best players out, I think everyone came with a good attitude, and we played with the next man up, and we played really smart hockey, and we got to our game. We had a game plan, and everyone played a huge role of tonight, and we're keeping it simple. We're not making it hard on ourselves right now, and everyone kind of knows their role right now, and we're playing good hockey.
Cameron Gantz told us that he had rarely, if ever, played forward, but that's how he opened it up, 11-7. He'll earn the assist on your goal. Take us through that goal and how you were able to finish.
Well, it was good. We got on the forecheck early. The puck came back up top. We had a good gap by Colby. Made a heck of a play. Gontcher made a DDD pass to Schenner, and I was just in that front. Been getting away from that lately and not getting in front of the net, and I found a way that Smitty was cheating there, and I bounced it off him. But all around, I thought, you know, it takes a lot of courage for Gontcher to step in a game like that. He's a natural defenseman to come in and step up, and he played a hell of a game, and, you know, he kept it simple. And first game forward in the NHL, I'm really impressed and just impressed by, you know, how he came and he gamed it out.
Now, finally here, Pat, is this evidence of the defensive focus of this team that you keep great players like Kreisheimer, Nugent Hopkins off the board with your focus in the middle of the ice?
Yeah, I think he just... You know, with an elite goalie back there like Vasi, I think he makes it easy for us. But a thing we've been talking about, like you just touched on, is just focus on 1-2-1 hockey games, 3-1 hockey games, because we're shutting it down and we're finding ways. I think come April, May, and June, you're not going to be winning games 5-4, 6-3. You're going to be winning games like tonight. So you got to find ways to nip it in the butt, and I think we've been doing a good job of that.
All right, Yanni, you ended the goal scoring drought the other night. You pick up another one. It had to feel pretty good at that time of the game again. Important goal for you.
I felt great. We had a big gap on the PK. We good step up there, heady angled and really well, and I just was able to pick it off and go on a breakaway. And fortunate enough to put it upstairs on him.
So what are you thinking as you're going down the ice? You had a lot of ice to kind of think about what you were going to do. At what point do you know you're going to make the move?
I don't think. I just go. Honestly, I just went, and when I picked up the puck, I actually thought he had a great gap. I actually thought he had a great gap on me, and I thought he was gonna. The bottom of the ice was open. It was closed, so I was surprised the puck went that high.
We know the resiliency this team showed you about in Pittsburgh. You played this game without Steven Stamkos, without Nikita Kucherov, Anthony Cirelli. To find another team kind of win, another team aspect, what's that mean for this group?
I mean, we're playing well. We're skating. We're playing hard. We're playing hard to play against, because like we close the middle of the ice. We track really hard, and when we do that, it just allows our D to have good gaps, and they probably feel like there's six players on the ice against us, and that's all we want to be playing, and that's all we've been playing lately.
Is that breed confidence through this, you know, 9-game winning streak now?
Yes, it does. I mean, for sure. And there's a lot of guys that stepped up tonight and did a very good job. And I think that just shows the depth of this this team, this organization. And it's really exciting to see.
You can't play forward tonight. You had Pointer pass up the empty netter to Paquette there. That unselfishness kind of theme throughout the team.
Yes. It just shows that this team is really close to each other, and we're a really tight group of guys, and that just shows it. And I mean, it's great to see. It's great to be part of it. It's so much fun, and I like what I'm seeing.
This group has, you know, you missed some of the players that you weren't missing tonight. You can go out and play another good style of game and pick up another key 2 points.
Yeah, of course, you don't want to see guys injured, you know, on your team. And I think everybody tonight put great effort, and everybody was working hard. We were doing the right things, and we won this game.
Yanni Gourde, we all know about the long goal drought that he ended the other night. For him to now have two goals in consecutive games here, what's he mean to this team, and how happy are you guys for him to start there?
He's a really good player for us, you know. Even if he didn't score goals those games, he was doing the right things. He was helping team all the time, you know, with his effort, with his work ethic and everything. What he's bringing for our team, and now it's even better when he's scoring those goals.
The play there in the first period, did you realize that Zach Cashin kind of kicked you in the chest there with a skate?
Yeah, I knew right away. He kicked me when he was on the ice. He was, I think, a little bit mad, and I asked him, like, what is wrong with him, you know, because that's not the right play what to do on the ice, and he didn't say nothing, so I don't know.
All the way through, or he gets in the padding there, I guess?
Yeah, he kicked me right to the chest, so luckily that wasn't higher.
Eric, you played so much with McDonough early on in the season, and he's been playing with Heaven now. How's that been with Victor?
That was amazing. He's probably best defenseman in the NHL, and always when you're playing with him, it's making everything easy for you, and I'm just trying to do right things with him, you know. Be there for him when he needs me, and I think everything is pretty good right now.
You've been playing some smart third periods, kind of shutting it down when you had that kind of short lead. Just what's been the key in that respect in terms of playing smart?
Yeah, of course, always when you have one goal lead, you try and play the good decision, you know, and a good play. So we were doing that all kind of 20 minutes, and work out for us.
Talk about your penalty kill. I mean, you guys have denied the number one power play twice tonight.
Yeah, I think all year we're doing a really good job in penalty kill. We are in our system, you know, we are clearing the zone when we have to and when we have the opportunity, and everything is doing the right things, and we are in a really good system, so we just have to keep doing that.